Accounting 12, Conceptual Framework and Accounting Standards. Statement of Cash Flows, Lecture 3. The following are the learning objectives. At the end of these topics, the student should be able to determine the objective and scope of Past 7. Identify the benefits of cash flow information. Describe the presentation of Statement of Cash Flows. Differentiate operating, investing, and financing activities. Discuss the presentation of taxes and dividends in the cash flow statement. Of Past 7, the Philippine Accounting Standard 7. The Philippine Accounting Standard 7 is the standard applicable for the accounting of statement of cash flows. The objective of IAS 7 is to require the presentation of information about the historical changes in cash and cash equivalents of an entity by means of a statement of cash flows, which classifies cash flows during the period according to operating, investing, and financing activities. Scope of Past 7. The requirements of this standard are applicable for the preparation and presentation of statement of cash flows. Ang sabi ko nga kanina, yung past 7, ito yung applicable standard for the preparation of the statement of cash flow. Aside from the Philippine Accounting Standard 1, yung Philippine Accounting Standard 1 kasi prescribe the guidelines for all of the financial statements including the statement of cash flows, which is presented as an essential component of the financial statements in each accounting period. Definition. So, what are the key definitions involved in the preparation of statement of cash flows? And statement of cash flow, so let's define cash. So, what is cash? Cash encompasses currency notes, coins used as currency, and short-term deposits accessible on demand. Meaning, pwede siyang gamitin agad-agad, like cash on hand or cash in bank, yung nakadeposit sa banko or other fund, na available siya for immediate use. We also have the cash equivalent. Cash equivalents are short-term investment which are highly liquid and are convertible into identifiable amount of cash within a period of 3 months or less. These have least chances of variation in value are termed as cash equivalent. Ito yung mga treasury bills or treasury notes na good for 3 months and then pwede na siya ma-convert into cash. So, short-term investments siya which are highly liquid na pag pina-convert mo siya or natapos na yung term niya is available na siya for use. So, those are cash equivalents. So, we have this illustration. Cash and cash equivalents. So, we have cash, like the cash on hand and the demand deposits. And we have also the cash equivalent. Example, yung mga short-term investment na good lang for 3 months or 2 months or 1 month. As long as within a period of 3 months or less lang yung term niya, short-term investment siya. So, classified siya as cash equivalent. So, definition, cash flows. Cash flows, the inflows and outflows in the normal conduct of the business. Ano yung pumapasok? Ano yung pinapalabas na cash sa entity? Of cash and cash equivalent are termed as cash flows. So, the statement of cash flow, yung minimindo na cash flow, both the inflow and outflow, not only of cash, but of cash and cash equivalents. Operating activities. Operating activities are the principal business activities of the entity which generate revenues for the entity are termed as operating activities. From the word operating, yung principal business activity, yung nasa operation. For example, yung sa buying and selling, yung sa pagbebenta, that is the operating activities of the entity. Yung pag-manufacture ng product, operating activities yan ni entity. We also have investing activities from the word investing. The activities which are undertaken by the entity for the purchase of long-term assets. Nag-i-invest tayo sa mga long-term assets in investments which are not the part of cash equivalents, including the disposal of such long-term assets and investment are termed as investing. Basta, related siya sa pag-purchase ng long-term assets, investment pa rin yan para sa entity, and investments na hindi siya part ng cash equivalents. For example, more than 3 months na, so hindi na yan part ng cash equivalents. Kasi nga yung definition natin ng cash equivalent kanina, at least yung term niya, 3 months or less. So, therefore, part yan siya ng investing activities. We also have financing activities. Financing activities, the activities which are undertaken by the entity to raise capital or long-term funds for the business and which result in change in the equity and borrowed funds of the entity are termed as financing activities. From the word financing, yung mga activities to finance the business. So, saan ba natin kinukuha yung pang-finance sa business natin or resources from the business? Yung, siyempre, nangungutang minsan si company or kaya from the equity, nag-i-issue siya ng shares or kaya nag-i-invest si owners, nag-i-invest si shareholders, nag-i-invest si investors or di kaya nag-uutang siya sa mga financial institutions. So, the activities which are undertaken by the entity to raise capital or long-term funds for the business, that is termed as financing activities. Mamaya, in the presentation of the statement of cash flows, nakakategory kasi the cash flow from operating activities, the cash flow from investing activities, and the cash flow from the financing activities. So, we should be familiar what are the activities that are classified as operating, as investing, or as financing. Presentation of the statement of cash flow. So, the presentation of statement of cash flow, the entity is required to prepare the statement of cash flow by classifying such cash flows into operating, investing, and financing activities. Cash flow from operating, cash flow from investing, and cash flow from financing activities. So, nakakategorize talaga siya sa statement of cash flow. Ano yung mga inflow or outflow from operating activities? Ano yung mga inflow and outflow from investing activities? Ano yung mga inflow or outflow from financing activities? So, dapat nakikita yun sa statement of cash flows. Category of cash flow. So, first we have cash flows from the operating activities. Cash flows from the operating activities reflects the cash generating ability of the operations and the extent to which such cash flows can be used to carry on operations. Example ng operating activities, the manufacturing of the product, the purchase, the acquisition of raw materials, the buying and selling of goods or inventory. So, those are the operating activities of the entity. Any cash received from the disposal of a non-current asset is not part of cash flow from operating activities. Instead, it is included in cash flow from investing activities. Against the definition natin kanina na investing activities, as long as involved ang long-term asset and long-term investment, under siya sa investing activities. So, kahit disposal pa yan, may na-receive tayo upon disposal or nung binenta yung non-current assets, yung for example, land or kaya machine, non-current asset yun, binenta natin, hindi siya magiging part ng operating activities since investment natin yun or long-term asset yun. Therefore, it must be part of the cash flow from the investing activities and not from operating activities. So, dapat ma-identify natin yung mga cash flow na dapat para sa operating, na ginagamit para sa operation ni company. Next, eto na yun. Cash flow from investing activities reflects the amount of expenditure made by the entity for the purchase of long-term assets to generate economic benefits for a long time period. So, hindi ibig sabihin na purchase of long-term assets lang, hindi nakasali yung pagbenta. So, pag nag-purchase ka ng long-term assets, including land, or kaya machines, or building, Okay. Yung inflow nun, or yung outflow pala nun, is classified as cash outflow from investing activities. Ngayon, pag binenta mo yun, since long-term asset yun, classified pa rin yun as cash inflow from investing activities. Next, cash flow from financing activities. Again, yung financing activities, ito yung mga activities used to raise funds or capital for the entity. So, the activities which are undertaken by the entity to raise capital and which result in change in the equity and borrowed funds of the entity are termed as financing activities. Bakit results in a change in the equity? Siyempre, pag nag-borrow tayo, maapektuhan yung liabilities natin at the same time, yung equity natin and then yung asset natin. Again, kung natatandaan nyo or discuss sa ibang subjects nyo, yung accounting equation natin, assets minus liabilities equals equity. So, there is a change in the equity once we are involved. Reporting cash flows from operating activities. The entity will report cash flow from operating activities either using direct method or indirect method. Direct method. Under direct method, the entity will present the gross cash inflows and outflows related to the major classes related to the operation which will be obtained from the accounts of the entity. Sa direct method kasi malalaman talaga natin kung saan galing yung cash inflows, kung saan galing yung cash outflows, so nakakategory siya. So for example, sales from the customer, cashes from the customer, so merong mga major classes, so matitrace natin. However, sa indirect method naman, the cash flow from operating activities are determined by adjusting the profit. So indirect, kasi dadaan tayo sa net income ni company. Since net income nagre-represent yan sa operation ni company, so dyan natin idadaan para makuha natin yung cash flow, net cash flow from operating activities under direct method. So ina-adjust yung profit or loss para makuha yung cash basis na income. And at the same time, para matanggal yung mga non-cash items dun sa, na na-include sa pag-compute ng income. For example, may mga non-cash items dun na na-recognize. For example, may mga sales na na-recognize na hindi pa naman talaga nakabayad ng cash. Katulad ng sinabi natin ng lecture 2, nagre-recognize tayo ng sales kahit wala pang cash na receive. Hindi yun applicable sa pag-prepare ng statement of cash flow. Kasi makikita lang natin sa statement of cash flow, dapat yung merong transaction na related sa cash. Ibig sabihin, meron talagang cash items. Kaya yung dito sa indirect method, from the profit or loss, kailangan natin i-adjust, tanggalin lahat nang na-deduct or na-add na wala namang effect sa cash. So, and also the items which are related to investing and financing. So, indirect method siya. Kasi hindi natin malalaman kung saan galing na category. Unlike dun sa direct method kasi nalaman natin, ito yung mga inflow galing sa customers, ito yung disbursement para sa operating expenses. So, nakikita dun sa direct method. So, yung direct method naman, dumadaan tayo sa profit or loss na nakareport sa income statement and then ina-adjust na lang natin yun. Tinatanggal natin yung mga non-cash items and at the same time, yung mga items na related sa investing and financing para mag-come up tayo, mag-result doon sa cash flow from operating activities. So, we have this illustration. Example, operating activities. Sa pag-prepare na operating activities, sa cash flow from operating activities, only from operating activities, kasi same lang ang presentation sa financing and investing. Sa operating activities, meron dalawang method, the direct method and the indirect method. Ito yung direct method, yung sinabi ko kanina na nakikita natin yung major classes. Ito yung natanggap natin from customers, ito yung binayad natin kay suppliers, kay employees, ito naman yung binayad natin interest o income tax period para makuha natin yung net cash from operating activities. Well, sa indirect method, same lang naman sila na magiging resulta. Iba lang yung method ng pag-present sa statement of cash flow. Sa indirect method naman, hindi siya magpe-present ng major classes kung saan ang galing yung inflow or outflow. Dadaan siya sa dun sa nakareport na net income or profit sa income statement. Then, i-adjust niya for non-cash items or changes in working capital. So, meron tayong cash from operation. Then, also the effect of interest paid and income tax paid. So, we have net cash from operating activity. Same lang naman to sila. So, in the conceptual framework and accounting standards, sa subject na ito, i-discuss lamang natin is theory. Yung computation nito, madediscuss nyo pag dating nyo sa higher accounting, sa intermediate accounting 2 or 3. Madediscuss nyo ang statement of cash flows computation. So, ngayon, let's just be familiar with the format of the direct method and the indirect method. Next, cash flows and foreign currency. So, the entity is required to adjust the cash flows and foreign currency as follows. So, the cash flows which arise from a foreign currency transaction will be presented in the functional currency of the entity using the exchange rate on the date of cash flow. So, in-adjust natin yung cash flow in the foreign currency, kailangan exchange lang yung exchange rate on the date of cash flow. For example, yung cash flow on January 31. So, since naka-foreign currency siya, i-convert natin. For example, yung statement of cash flow is presented in Philippine peso. So, therefore, i-convert natin siya in Philippine peso using the exchange rate on the date of cash flow on January 31. Okay. Ano ba ang exchange rate? So, for example, 50. For example, 50. So, therefore, kailangan i-convert siya into Philippine peso. For example, yung cash flow from in foreign currency is 100. Okay, equivalent niya sa Philippine peso, $100 per Philippine peso, 50 per dollar. So, 100 times 50. So, we have 5,000 pesos. Yun dapat yung nakapresent sa statement of cash flows. So, again, using the exchange rate on the date of cash flow. So, pag nag-prepare tayo ng statement of cash flow at December 31, then merong cash flow in foreign currency January 31, kailangan natin i-convert yung cash flow and na cash inflow on that date based on the exchange rate on that date and not on the date kung saan tayo nag-prepare ng financial statements or kung kailan tayo nag-prepare ng statement of statement of cash flows. Cash flows related to a foreign subsidiary will be translated using the exchange rate on the date of cash flow. The same concept with number one. So, cash flow related to foreign subsidiary, since in foreign currency yan, kailangan siya translate into Philippine peso using the exchange rate on the date of cash flow, not on the date when the financial statements or the statement of cash flows are being prepared. So, for example, in December 31, may prepare na tayo, and then yung mga cash flows meron in foreign currency. So, kailangan i-translate muna natin sila based on the exchange rate on the date na na-realize natin yung cash flows or pumasok sila or na-disburse natin sila from the cash of the entity. The exchange gain and loss related to foreign currency transaction. Ano to? Pag nag-translate po kasi tayo from foreign currency into Philippine peso, meron kasi tayong tinatawag na exchange gain or loss. Yung computation nito, madadiscuss nyo pagdating nyo ng higher accounting. So, the exchange gain and loss related to foreign currency transaction are unrealized. Therefore, are treated as non-cash items in the preparation of the statement of cash flow. Take note nyo lang ito. The deeper discussion of this is under advanced accounting subject. So, pagdating nyo pa yata ng third year. Interest and dividends. So, anong classification ni interest and dividends paid or received sa statement of cash flows. So the entity will account for the cash flows related to interest and dividends as follows. For the interest and dividend income, either be presented under operating activities. Kasi diba sa under operating activities, usually dumadaan tayo sa net income. And we know that interest income and dividend income is part of the determination of profit or loss. So usually, kasali sila sa computation ng profit or loss ng entity. Minsan din, kinaklassify siya as it may also be classified as investing activities. Kasi nare-receive din naman natin sila or nare-receive natin sila pag nag-invest tayo, interest and dividend income. Pag nag-invest tayo sa long-term investment, nagkaroon, nag-purchase tayo ng long-term investment, kaya nagkaka-receive tayo ng interest income or dividend income. So, kaya pwede siyang maklasify either as operating or either as investing. So, again, pwede siyang maklasify as operating activities kasi nga, the interest and dividend income are both part of the determination of profit or loss. And also, it can be classified as investing activities kasi nga, it is also part of the cost of obtaining returns on investments. Cost of obtaining of resources kung saan tayo nag-acquire. And at the same time, sa part natin na nag-invest, return on investment natin, si interest income and dividend income. Therefore, it can be classified as under investing activities. The interest expense can either be presented under operating activities or under financing activities. Yung tinutukoy dito, yung interest paid, yung cash outflow. It either be presented under operating. Bakit? Kasi nga, it is part of the determination din ng profit or loss or the net income. So, it could be classified as under operating activities or under financing activities. Why? Kasi yung interest expense, ma-incur lang natin pag nangutang tayo. Okay? So, under financing activities because it is the one of the costs of obtaining resources. So, makaka-incur tayo kaya tayo nagbabayad ng interest kasi nangutang tayo, which is under financing activity. So, therefore, interest paid is either presented or under operating activities or under financing activities. Next, we have the dividend paid. The dividend paid naman, either represented under operating activities or under financing activities. The same explanation with the interest expense. So, etong tatlo, kung mapapansin nyo, interest and dividend income, interest expense and dividend paid, they can either be presented under operating activities. So, non-cash items. The entity will not take into account the effect of non-cash items such which are relating to investing and financing activities such as anong treatment natin sa non-cash items? Malamang hindi dapat siya ma-present sa statement of cash flow. Kasi yung statement of cash flow from the statement of cash flows. Ibig sabihin yung pumasok lang or lumabas na cash from the entity or to the entity. So, therefore, yung mga non-cash items dapat excluded siya sa pag-prepare ng statement of cash flow. For example, the purchase of a non-current asset on credit. Bumili ka nga ng long-term asset or kaya nag-acquire ka nga ng long-term investment, iutang naman, inutang mo. For example, bumili ka ng building, pero utang yung building, therefore, hindi ka naman nagpalabas ng cash. So, therefore, wala dapat cash outflow na ma-present sa statement of cash flow under investing activities pertaining doon sa transaction na yun. Another example, purchase of a subsidiary by issue of equity instrument. Yun, nag-purchase ka ng another company ng subsidiary by issue of equity instrument. Pero hindi din cash yung pinangbayad mo. Nag-issue ka lang ng shares sa company na yon. So, therefore, wala din cash outflow. Therefore, though this transaction is financing activities or this transaction may be under investing activities, this cannot be classified or hindi siya pwedeng makategory, hindi siya pwedeng ma-include sa presentation ng statement of cash flow since walang cash na na-involve. Again, yung mga items lang na ma-include dun sa operating activities, investing activities, saka financing activities na nasa statement of cash flow, yung mga cash items lang. And the bonus issue. Bonus issue, wala pa rin tong cash related na payment or inflow. Disclosures. IAS 7 requires an entity to disclose the components of cash and cash equivalents and to present a reconciliation of the amounts in the statement of cash flows with the equivalent items reported in the statement of financial position. Yung total cash and cash equivalents kasi, since asset to, nakapresent to sa statement of financial position. Pero, yung reconciliation of the amounts, for example, yung beginning cash and cash equivalent, 10,000, yung ending cash and equivalent, 100,000, bakit naging ganito? Anong pumasok sa entity? Anong pinalabas? Anong ginastos ng entity? So, lahat yun makikita sa statement of cash flow. Yung reconciliation of the amount of the cash and cash equivalent is presented in the statement of cash flows. Reading assignment. Read PAS 7, the whole PAS 7, the statement of cash flows. If there are topics that you really can't understand or if you have any questions or clarification, please leave your message on our Schoology course group discussion. This is the end of Lecture 3. Thank you. God bless.